Hi, everyone. So, America is a mess right now, okay? And the reason why America is a mess is because of bad guns. And bad guns are the reason why America is such a mess. And because Donald Trump is a racist, he refuses to let us take all of America's guns. So, whoopee for all of you gun owners out there with bad guns, okay? You get to keep your guns because your president is a racist. But fortunately for all of you, I know how to think. And because I know how to think, I went out and bought my own gun today. Now, I've never owned a gun. And up until recently, I didn't even own a garbage disposal. But now, I own both, okay? And I'm going to teach you a few tricks on how to make your gun nicer. I'm gonna teach you how to make your gun behave and to be obedient when you tell your gun to do something. Now, I have been a gun owner for about 3 hours, okay? And I can tell you this, my gun is more well-behaved than all of your guns out there right now in America. And you know why? The reason why is because I'm an involved gun owner. I'm not just some lazy gun owner that goes to Walmart and buys a gun because Donald Trump's a racist. I bought a gun to prove a point and to teach my gun how to be well-behaved. And today, I'm gonna teach you how to teach your gun how to be well-behaved. Okay, so the first step in having a well-behaved gun is showing your gun respect. And the way you show your gun respect is giving your gun a name. And the reason why you give your gun a name is because guns, they have feelings. And people with feelings deserve to have a name. You show your gun respect, your gun will show you respect. I name my gun Daisy. Daisy shows me respect, I show Daisy respect. Let's move along to step two. Now, step two in having a well-behaved gun is about discipline. Okay? Now, just because you go to the store and buy a gun, it doesn't stop there, okay? I don't just let my gun, or Daisy, walk around the house and do whatever she wants to do. There are rules, okay? And there are consequences if Daisy breaks the rules, okay? So, in order for Daisy to walk around the house, she needs to ask me permission. Other than that, she stays exactly where she is, or there will be consequences. Okay, let's move along to step three. Now, step three in having a well-behaved gun is all about training. Now, I've been a gun owner for about 3 hours, and I have already taught my gun how to sit. I said, Daisy, sit. Then I taught her how to lay down. I said, Daisy, lay down. And she laid down. Then I told her, stay. And Daisy, she stayed. I showed her respect. She showed me respect. In order to have a well-behaved gun, your gun needs to understand that you are in charge. And if they don't follow your orders, they will be placed in a timeout. If you raise a gun to be good and respectful, it will grow up to be good and respectful. But if you raise a gun to be bad, it's gonna grow up to be bad. Now, I'm not just gonna stop at teaching guns how to be well-behaved. I am also teaching cigarettes how to sit. I'm also teaching drugs how not to show up in your purse. And then I'm also teaching alcohol not to open itself and put itself in a glass, okay? These are things that I'm doing while I'm in Congress. You're welcome.